Hello and welcome to another episode of Supercalifanilistic. My name is Christian Rauchenwald, and today I want to talk to you about something very basic that most people already have heard, the phrase, you get what you pay for. Now, before we talk about that and why I want to talk about it today, I actually want to, as always, quickly welcome everyone who tunes in for the first time to one of my episodes. Make sure that you hit that subscribe button in the bottom right corner somewhere down here so you don't miss out any future content. Now, let's talk about you get what you pay for. Almost everybody on this planet has already heard it. That phrase, it exists pretty much in every language, and there is a reason for it, because it's most often true. If you sign up for cheap trainings that are like $9 per month, $10 per month, $10 one time, $50 one time, well, you get what you pay for. You know, like, there are some cases where training provides with more value, or an item provides with more value than what you pay for. But in most cases, if something is cheap, it means it's sold in high quantity. It also means it doesn't really go into depth. It doesn't really teach you a lot in terms of trainings, because it's usually, not always, there are trainings out there for sure, like the One Funnel Away Challenge for $100, which is worth way more. I'm gonna circle back to that later and explain why it's the case there. But for most trainings, it will simply mean if they are very cheap, they are pre-recorded, they don't go very deep, you will not have any personal feedback or a way to ask questions when you don't understand the content or how it's delivered. Sorry, and therefore you won't be able to take that much away from it. So instead of paying like $50 here, $20 there, $97 here, you should rather consider investing in like those trainings out there that are made by people that are already on the market longer, that are entrepreneurs, not only for a couple of weeks or months, but actually know how to run their business and are on the market for a couple of years. And therefore they may also, because they're so experienced, charge you a little bit more, but may also include a way for you to actually get in touch with them or with their employees that are also trained to provide you with additional feedback. An example for that would be the coaching program about organic traffic that I talked about in yesterday's video by Rachel S. Lee, which is a little bit more expensive, with I think $497 if I recall it right, but you can check it out by watching the video that I put in the card up here. And also offers you group coaching. So while you will not have like personal calls with Rachel S. Lee, you will have a group coaching environment where you will also get feedback from her and or her team. And therefore you'll get more value out of it. Yes, you could sign up for 10 cheaper trainings for the same amount of money, but you will not be able to take as much away. It's also, when you look at people that hire coaches, for example, and pay those coaches thousands of dollars every month, most of them you will see eventually posting that they recoup that investment in a couple of weeks or months easily based on what they learned from that coach. It's because I saw a nice quote about it, like, yes, I can do it in 30 minutes, but you're not pay. But it took me 10 years to be able to do it in 30 minutes. So you're not paying me for the 30 minutes, you're paying me for the 10 years experience. Yeah. And that's the same thing with trainings and coachings and everything else that is out there. Yes, sometimes things are overpriced and somebody just tries to make more money with something that's not worth that amount of money. Yeah, the same thing applies when you start to buy, I don't know, clothes from Gucci, Prada, and so on. You also pay for the brand. A cap, a baseball cap from Gucci costs around $300, for example. The materials are for sure premium compared to the average baseball cap that you can buy, but they are by far not worth the $300, so it's overpriced. Yeah, and the same applies to some of the coachings, but overall you always get what you pay for. Yeah, if you're looking for free and cheap, you will end up wasting a lot of your time. You will still spend most of your money, but you will not see any results. It simple is like that. There may be a few exceptions out there, but for the majority of people and for the majority of offers out there, it simply is true. It's like with everything else, you know, like if you buy a laptop for $300, well, it will work and you may be able to somehow get the job done, but everything will take longer because it will have a slower CPU, it will have less RAM, it will have a slower hard drive, and so on, compared to a $1,000 laptop or a $2,000 MacBook Pro or something like that. Yeah, so don't forget that. Like, don't forget that when you spend money, and I'm talking not about like buying luxury clothing or cars or something like that, but when it's about your business and about your education, which you again use in your business, then don't, I don't know, like don't go for the cheap offers. Go for the good offers. Yeah, price should not matter then. Like, it's not, oh, it's so expensive, I cannot afford it. If you've read Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad Poor Dad, you should know it's so expensive. How can I afford it? What do I need to do to be able to buy that great coaching program? For example, if you were in multi-level marketing, you could sign up for hundreds of different small trainings for a couple of dollars, or you can sign up for Steven Larsen's MLM Hacks training, which will set you back $1,000. It's a $997 investment. You can find a link down in the description below if you are in network marketing and haven't taken it yet. Yeah. But it comes from one of the people that actually crushes it in network marketing without bothering friends and family, and knows what he's talking about, has proven over and over again that he knows what he's talking about, knows how to build funnels, knows how to do marketing and all that stuff. Yeah. And it provides you with the information that you can actually use to grow your business. And again, the choice is yours. You can go to somebody who's like, says like, oh, if you open your ClickFunnels account through my link, I will give you my share funnels, yeah, and you will be like, sweet, I save some money, yeah, and you will not have any progress because you will have share funnels that you don't know how to use them. Or you can be like, okay, I don't care more or less who I sign up with, but I need to invest in the training by Steven Larsen so I actually have firsthand a step-by-step guide on how to grow my multi-level marketing or network marketing business online. And again, you will get what you pay for. It will always be like this. If you try to save money on your education, you actually save on results. You will have less profits, you will have less results, and in the end you will be more unhappy than if you just invest. Yeah. And the same goes with, since I'm doing a little bit ClickFunnels support, as most of you know, as a ClickFunnels expert, I see people spending hours trying to figure out how to set up their domain, for example, instead of just paying a freelancer from Funnel Rolodex maybe $50 or $20 or $100, it doesn't matter. They rather spend half their day and get frustrated instead of actually working on what brings them money and just paying a professional to get it done. Like, with that mentality, you will never achieve success. It just doesn't work like this. Yes, there are some things that you can and should learn and should do yourself, but there are also other things where it's like you get what you pay for. If you're not willing to pay anything, you will sacrifice tons of your hours of your time, days of your time. You will be frustrated and you will not be able to get other things done that you need to get done in order to generate sales. Yeah. And even if you get it somehow done, the setup might not be done properly. So like, you know, like I could create a million clickbaity videos about how to make $100 per day or something to get more views on the YouTube channel. But instead I'm actually trying to teach each and every one of you something with each and every one of my videos. Yeah. Like, yes, I know you're probably not able to take away something from every video, and some of the things you may already be aware of, but then it's always good to, you know, like get a reminder to be like more considerate about it. Like this today, I'm sure you've already heard about the phrase, you get what you pay for, but I'm also sure that many of you that are watching my videos do not always consider it. Yeah. Like, most people run around asking for free advice all the time. And I'm not talking about contacting me or stuff like that. Yeah. I anyway only reply when I have time, and I only dedicate a certain amount for free or to help people out for free, since I'm also running a business here. Yeah. But I'm talking about asking in Facebook groups where they know everybody else in that group is an entrepreneur that first and foremost is in this group for their own benefit. Yeah. And then they expect to get professional free advice and not something that's tainted by a drive to promote oneself. Yeah. And so, whatever it is you're doing, whatever your business is, your industry is, if you're just starting out, if you already are running a business and you're looking for ways to scale it up, like, don't save money on the wrong things. Like, if you want to know how things are done, hire the right people that have experience that can show you how it's done, or they can get it done for you. Yeah. If you want to learn more yourself, invest in the trainings. Yeah. Like, do you think, like, if somebody really has an amazing training that really teaches a lot, like, how big is the chance that they will give it away for free or for $10 or something like that? Yeah. Ask yourself, if you would be the best network marketer using funnels there is, and you would create a course that contains I don't know how many hours of video material, would you just post it for free, or would you be like, oh sweet, that course is actually like gonna help so many people, I'm gonna get paid for my work here, and you're gonna put a price tag to it that matches the value? Or like, I guess, like, I don't know, for some reason it's like when people start hiring freelancers from third world countries, like from Bangladesh or something, and suddenly they expect them to work for $6 per hour, but then they would not be willing to provide their services to them for $6 per hour. It doesn't make sense. You all want to get paid, so also you need to be willing to invest and pay others. Doesn't matter if it's about courses, about your hardware that you buy, whatever it is. If you wanna make six or wanna make progress, if you wanna become successful, yes, there is a ton of free advice. Yes, you also get a ton of stuff, for example, from my YouTube videos and tutorials and stuff like that. Yeah, I'm sure about that. But if you wanna have the real gems and the one-on-one experience, like either with me or with anybody else out there who knows what they're talking about and who has like years of experience as an entrepreneur in a certain niche or stuff like that, well, then you will need to pay the price. Like, everybody considers his time valuable, and all of us entrepreneurs are in this. Yes, we want to help people, but first and foremost, everyone is selfish. Like, we all think about ourselves. Yeah, instead of working 40 hours in some random company and going home with a paycheck, I'm doing this so I'm my own boss. I can decide when I work, when I take a rest, when I take a vacation and stuff like that. That's why I'm doing this. That's also the reason why I'm charging for my time, where others are charging for my time. Why not all the content I'm creating is available free, but for example, costs $200 to get access to the video trainings, or even more, yeah? So do yourself a favor, like think about it. Like, again, everything comes back. It's fascinating. Usually everything comes back to treat everyone the way you want to be treated. Yeah. And you can modify that phrase and think about it. Like, how would you handle it? If you have valuable content, if you created a valuable course, how likely is it that you would give it away for free? Yes, there are some people out there like Billie Jean, for example, that then have already a huge following and a huge amount of customers and a huge amount of monthly recurring revenue that then drop things for free, or like his birthday offers where there was one course for $1, which was worth more than that $1. I'm not going to say it was worth thousands of dollars, but it was definitely worth more than that $1. But then again, they can still make a huge revenue because of their huge following. So they still only do it as a marketing stunt on their birthday. Yeah. So, and if we go back to ClickFunnels One Funnel Away challenge, why is that challenge worth more than thousands of dollars and is available for $100? It's very simple, because for ClickFunnels, it's a part of their value ladder. They don't consider monetizing or maximizing the profit or getting what it's worth from this challenge. They consider it as a stepping stone. The free affiliate bootcamp, the free 30-day series, both free content, both amazing, and both a stepping stone to get you to get your ClickFunnels account, where ClickFunnels makes their monthly revenue from you, and followed by the free books, which also are worth more than the few dollars that you pay for shipping, where ClickFunnels probably doesn't earn that much. And then followed by the $100 One Funnel Away challenge, where mostly the affiliates get their $100 commission and ClickFunnels doesn't earn anything. All of those are stepping stones to get you into ClickFunnels, where ClickFunnels was able to grow from 0 to 100 million in revenue per year in 3 years, because they're giving that away way under its real value. Yeah. But if you are looking for, I don't know, like if somebody out there, I don't know if Steven Larsen, I know he has Funnel Stash and he has MLM Hacks, but I don't know if he has any other courses. If he would build like a whole set of multi-level marketing courses, then he would also most likely create a lower level that's cheap or even free, that shows you some introduction steps, and then build it up to a monthly membership that you pay. But because there's only this one course, he has to price it for the value he deems it's worth and the market says it's worth, because they're willing to pay that amount of money for it. Yeah. And that's why that training costs $1,000. But if you sign up for the training and follow it, well, you will also get way more than the $1,000 out of it, because you will have more success with your multi-level marketing business. However, if you sign up with any random affiliate who offers you a random training or course or something, that's basically, I don't know, it may be even worth something to you because you may be a total beginner and that person may already have 2 months or a year in experience, yeah, but it just doesn't compare to somebody who has years of experience and a proven track record of success in that niche, yeah. So yeah, that's where I want to leave it for today. Sorry that the video got a little bit longer, but I really wanted to share that again. I think I probably already talked about it before, but I just wanted to make sure, you know, that you guys really think about this like that, and obviously you girls as well, that you never forget you get what you pay for. It's true so often. If somebody is helping you a lot for free, it's great, and they may be even able to help you a lot, but also consider if somebody is offering free advice to you over and over again, he does it most likely because eventually he expects that something will come back. He may not, he may not phrase it like this, but there's still these expectations. Well, maybe I get a recommendation, maybe they buy that other course of me and stuff like that, yeah. So, and don't become one of those people that abuse those free help. Yeah, again, treat everybody the way you want to be treated. If you are helping somebody for free along the way, you probably would also draw the line somewhere and say, you know what, we've reached a point where I just cannot spend my time anymore on you unpaid, because, you know, like, I also have to make a living somehow. Yeah, that's it for today. Yeah, nothing I want you to do, actually, so no comment needed or something. Like, yeah, or actually let me know in the comments below if you also like sometimes catch yourself hunting the cheaper offer or looking too much on the price instead of the value. And yeah, there's also a saying, I think it was the CEO of Prada that said it, like, quality is what's left, or value is what's left when the price has been long forgotten. Yeah. So if you have, like, if you sign up for, so really the last thing I'm saying in this video, yeah. So if you sign up for a lot of cheap trainings, you will, and don't have any results, you will always remember the money you spent and that it didn't work and me and so on. Yeah. Or if you invested in the right coaches and the right training, well, you will forget the price because suddenly you will have the success that comes based from that. Yeah. So thanks for watching. See you tomorrow with another video. Till then, bye bye. Thank you for watching this video. If it provided you with any value whatsoever, don't forget to like it by hitting that thumbs up button down below. And also, to ensure you don't miss out any future content, go ahead right now and click on the subscribe button down below. Now, last but not least, the only thing left for you to do is actually pick which of the following two videos you want to see next, and I'll see you there.